Hello, our viewers. Welcome to Ask Dr. Uthman YouTube channel. I told you this is your channel where you learn medicine at the comfort of your living room. Today we have a question from one of our followers on Facebook, Nakadu Jamaima. She says, "Hello, Doc. I am 28 years old. Went to the hospital yesterday and I was told that I have a cyst on my tubes. First, I mean, is it curable and can I ever become pregnant? Continue with me in this video to learn the following. Number one, what are cysts? Two, how do you know that you have a cyst? Those are signs and symptoms of a cyst. What causes cysts? How can you treat them and what are the complications of these cysts? I mean, can you become pregnant when you have a cyst? Can you menstruate with a cyst?"
Ask Dr. Uthman.
So a cyst is a thin-walled soft mass which is filled with fluids or semi-fluids. It's actually like a polythene bag which is filled with water. Take a look at this. This is how a cyst looks like. So a cyst looks like this. This is how a cyst looks like. Very soft, very, very soft with a thin layer. And these cysts can be found all over the human body. However, in the interest of this question, we are going to talk about cysts found on the ovary, fallopian tubes, and those cysts found in the pelvic organ. So we need to understand what causes or what brings about these cysts. Most of these cysts are caused by infections. Infections, especially the pelvic inflammatory diseases or PIDs that are not treated, poorly treated, or that are recurrent. When they persist in the body, they may end up forming cysts. Actually, some other cysts are caused by hormonal imbalance, especially during menstruation and all ovulation. Some other cysts happen during pregnancy. Actually, they happen in the early life of pregnancy, and their role is to support this early pregnancy until the placenta is formed. They don't usually persist after the formation of the placenta. However, if they persist until the late pregnancy, then they can be removed during delivery. And how can you know all what are the signs that can show you that you probably have a cyst? Number one, most women have lower abdominal pain. Pain that occurs just below your umbilicus may be one of the suggestions that you have a cyst. Number two is the dyspareunia. By dyspareunia, I mean pain during sexual intercourse. And this usually happens during penetrative sex. Another issue is the abnormal vaginal bleeding. Then other signs come as a result of the progression of the cyst. When this cyst becomes big, it causes pressure symptoms. By pressure symptoms, we mean the cyst compresses on some other structures in the pelvic organ, pelvic region, for example, the bladder and the rectum. When it compresses the bladder, you'll have increased frequency of micturition or increased frequency of urination. And once it compresses on the rectum, I mean one of the big intestines in the body. When it is compressed, you'll have tenesmus. By tenesmus, tenesmus is a condition whereby someone feels like they want to do poo-poo, but when they go there, they don't do anything. And to you, my viewer, the most important aspect here is to know how you are going to overcome the cyst. So what you do is you must first undergo some tests. You do some blood tests, the CBC, and so many tests when you go to the hospital. You also need to do a scan to confirm the presence and the size of the cyst. However, what you should understand is that most of these cysts will resolve on their own. Actually, they will go away without any treatment. But those that persist without treatment really require to be treated. And there are two modes of treatment. Number one, the medical treatment, and then the surgical treatment. Medical, you'll give it in cases whereby the cause is really known. For example, if you have infections, the PIDs we talked about, you are going to take antibiotics. Your doctor will give you antibiotics, and once these infections are treated, then the cyst will go away. Then for hormonal issues, you'll be able to take contraceptive pills. Your doctor will discuss with you and see the medicines they can give you to treat these cysts. Now, there are cysts that cannot go away on their own, and secondly, they cannot go away with medication. These cysts require surgery. What are the indications of surgery? When will you go for surgery? Number one, if the cyst is large, you will sit with your doctor and he will tell you that really this cyst is very big, especially cysts above 5 centimeters. However, when I say 5 centimeters, don't go to your doctor and tell them, you know, for me, they told me when the cyst is above 5 centimeters, I should go for surgery. No, you must discuss with this person because there are some other factors that should be looked at before a decision is taken. So if the cyst is large, that is 5 centimeters and above, it requires a surgery. Another issue is a persistent cyst. This cyst may happen this month, you treat it with antibiotics, 3 months later another cyst, in a period of 1 year you have 4 cysts, then the cyst may also require a surgery. But of course, this also depends on the discussion you are going to have with your doctor. Then there are those cysts that are painful and you cannot bear the pain, so this cyst may also require a surgery. Then lastly, hemorrhagic cysts. By hemorrhagic cysts, I mean the cysts that bleed. Someone has severe pervaginal bleeding. It may require a surgery. Bottom line, it requires a discussion between you, your family, and your doctor to come up with a conclusion of surgery. However, the choice of surgery should also depend on, number one, the person's age, and secondly, the fertility intentions. By fertility intentions, I mean whether this woman still wants to give birth or they produced and they don't want to give any birth to any more children. The types of surgeries done, we have the cystectomy. Cystectomy means removing. You just go in and remove the cyst and leave everything the way it is. However, we have another surgery called oophorocystectomy. By oophorocystectomy, we remove this cyst plus also the ovary, because most cysts are attached on the ovary and the fallopian tube. So sometimes you may remove the fallopian tube and the ovary, and sometimes also the tube itself. Then lastly, we can do a TA, or a total abdominal hysterectomy. By total abdominal hysterectomy, we are removing the whole uterus, we are removing everything. So this really requires you to have an individualized talk with your doctor to identify your choices. And also, it will depend on the severity and the massiveness of the cyst. In conclusion, as I'm answering my friend Jamaima and other viewers, you should understand that someone can conceive, someone can continue with their regular menstruation with a cyst. However, it depends on the type of the cyst and also the severity. So, bottom line is you need to go to the hospital, visit your doctor, have several examinations, get checked, and understand your prognosis. Thank you very much for watching Ask Dr. Uthman YouTube channel. I told you this is your channel where you learn medicine at the comfort of your living room. I sign out. Ask Dr. Uthman.